Now, when you use WordPress.com, your website is already hosted for you. All you need to do is sign up for an account and you're ready to go. You can think of WordPress.com like you're renting a house. However, with WordPress.org, you need to find a web host to host your website. A web host basically gives you a little area on the internet where you can upload your website to make it visible to the world. You can think of WordPress.org like you own the house. WordPress.com is fully maintained and controlled by the WordPress staff. But with the .org, you maintain and have full control of your website. This means that WordPress.com lacks customization and flexibility, especially when you compare it to WordPress.org. Also, WordPress.com is part of a larger network of blogs, whereas in WordPress.org, the site is independent. Let's take a look at the domain name differences for the two types of WordPress. Just so you know, a domain name is the address name of your website. So for example, my domain name is www.peterstavro.com. Now, if you decide to go with WordPress.com, your domain name by default will look like this. But with WordPress.org, you need to register your own domain name. Now, the main difference between the two is that with WordPress.com, it is very expensive to buy a domain name. But with WordPress.org, buying a domain name is very cheap. You can usually get one for around $13. Another thing we need to look at is storage space. With WordPress.com, you get 3 GB free storage space. With WordPress.org, you need to find a web host, but almost all hosting services offer more than 3 GB of storage space. With WordPress.com, you can buy additional space, but buying space is much more expensive than buying space for your own hosted website. Themes are very closely related to customization. WordPress.com has a limited selection of free themes, whereas WordPress.org has thousands of free and premium themes available. Premium themes with WordPress.com cost much more, and they are not very unique when you compare them to the themes available in WordPress.org, in which you can use to make your website look very unique. Plugins are also related to customization, and they basically allow you to easily add additional functionality to your website. A contact form, for example. In WordPress.com, there are no plugins available, but with WordPress.org, there are thousands of free and premium plugins. Also with WordPress.com, there is limited opportunities for new features and functionalities, unlike in WordPress.org, where you can add any feature or functionality that you want. Lastly, let's talk about making money. With WordPress.com, you are not allowed to have any ads, but they display their own ads on your website. With WordPress.org, you can basically do whatever you want, which is why I highly recommend that you use WordPress.org and not WordPress.com.